the Marquise was also a little bit afraid when the Aurora was like dancing and stuff like she did tonight. Yes, because they believe it was like Valkyries coming down to get their souls, like spirits coming down to get their souls. And also here by the coast of Norway, some people still call the Aurora the Wind Lights, because their great-grandparents believed it was the wind that was moving the Aurora, making it dance. Nowadays, you know it's not true because there's no weather up where the Aurora is. Like, the Aurora starts at 60 kilometers, the ozone layer is between 20 and 30 kilometers, and the airline flies at 12 kilometers. But they actually believed it was the wind that was moving it. And some young people today still call the Aurora the Wind Lights just to preserve that ancient name of the Aurora. And that is actually quite cool that they're doing that. And also, I remember when I was a little kid, like 5-6 years old, my parents told me that if I waved or whistled to the Aurora, she would come down and get me or knock me over or something. So I just, okay mom, okay dad, I went out playing with my friends and it got dark and of course the Aurora came out. And I just ran home screaming, I was so afraid. And the magic is happening because high above us, from approximately 60 kilometers and up to 500 to 700 kilometers above us, those charged particles will collide in a way with different atoms of gases we have up there. And when they do, the energy released from that collision is released in form of light. And trillions and trillions and trillions of those collisions is what we see as the Aurora. And that also determines the color we have on the Aurora. So if we have like a green Aurora lower down and a red one higher up, that means that the charged particles are hitting oxygen atoms. That will create the green and the red line. But if we have like the purple in the bottom and the blue higher up, that means that it's hitting nitrogen atoms. So that was what was happening when we had the purple above us.